This year's pavilion was designed by Junior Ishigami, a Japanese architect. The particular challenge this year, it was being able to suspend 61 tons of slate on a thin metal structure, which wanted to be as small and slight as possible. Now, each one of these supporting columns, because it's an arch, every single one of the top connections was bespoke to that one column. So we had 106 different connection points at the top of each column, and each one had to be individually drawn, individually engineered, no repeat process. I think there's sort of $2,000 of CAD work in there. 2 months of three people solidly drawn. Well, the roof was a particular challenge in the fact that they had to lay 61 tons of slate. Now, in order to lay 61 tons of slate, we actually sent 67 tons of slate to site, and they had to shape each individual piece of slate to fit in the exact position where they needed it to fit. So we actually chipped away 7 tons of slate from the actual piece of slate we sent down. Well, the team that's been on site is more or less the team that's been on previous pavilions. Tiff's the project manager. He kind of keeps everybody in line on site and directs what happens on site and keeps the program going. And the lads, you've got Al and the rest of the team who are there every year, and we try to keep the same team because they know how the gallery works, they know how the Royal Parks work. So having the same team is a massive advantage.
Barbie's the main crew chief, but she'll tell you what to do. But
I mean, we'll pair up differently depending on the task and who's best for the task or who's best to run that task. And we'll pair everyone up with their particular skills.
So you two are a pair?
Yeah. But not a couple. The mesh has probably took the most time out of everything so far. Direction of which way all the beams run and getting it up into place and welding it took a long time. That was a 2 week period.
Because every side of the mesh has got like a steel rod coming off, like every 150 mil, and each one has to be fully welded on top of a timer. So you can see how many grids there are on there. There's a lot of welding to them. I think it will look quite smart when it's done.
It'll all look good in the end. Once the fence is down and the landscaping's being done, it changes it completely again.